Good afternoon, Sir Mark. Good afternoon, fellow classmates. We are Group B and we are presenting the barriers and benefits of research in healthcare practice. So first of all, the members is Sanjay, JP, and Lynn and Israel. So we want to talk about what is research first. Research is a process of systematic inquiry that entails collection of data, documentation of critical information, and analysis interpretation of information in accordance with suitable methodologies. So we're using research in healthcare in order to help doctors to find more effective therapies for their patients. In health social cares, they strive to find new information that will influence improvements to healthcare legislations and treatments. Sanjay, please.
That's why the present goal for me to
Exactly, it paid off. Everything paid off actually. All of us struggles with this corona, but finally research came through.
The vaccine dramatically reduced the number of severe cases, hospitalization, deaths. They saved countless lives. The impact on the mental health and economy. Business could reopen. People could see their loved ones again, and there was a general sense of hope that things were going back to the normal again.
It wasn't perfect, of course. There were breakthrough infections, but overall, the benefits of the research are undeniable.
You're right, Plana. The research is still the overlay. They're still working and improving the strategy and the vaccine.
Absolutely, it's a continuous process and understand for states to research.
Yeah, cheers to research. Hopefully, it's not only COVID-19 vaccines that they will try to produce, but let's see, maybe other diseases too.
So, during the dialogue between the caregiver highlights just some of the benefits of the research on COVID-19 vaccines. While there are many, there may be a challenges and questions along the way, the impact of the research is saving lives, improving health, and fostering hopeful future is undeniable.
The next scene is the barriers of research in practice. Doctor will be Sanjay. Sanjay will be Dr. Sanjay. She's a passionate young physician eager to integrate research into patient care. And then we have Dr. JP. He's a skeptical physician concerned about prioritizing research over patients. Nurse Edlin and Nurse Rada, nurses and practical nurses focus on daily patient needs. The scene is also on the hospital lounge, and then they will talk about the barriers. Dr. Sanjay entered the lounge, visibly excited when welcoming her doctor.
Everyone, wait, I got very exciting news. My proposal for diabetes management problem has been approved finally. And this is going to be a game changer for every one of our patients.
The diabetes management program is a personalized patient plans based on genetic analysis, real-time data through wearable devices.
That's fantastic, Dr. Sanjay. But let's be honest. We're so busy. Another research project in our regular busy.
That is right. Research is great, but we cannot let it interfere with primary treatment of primary care.
The primary duty of healthcare providers is taking care of the patients in front of them. What if they don't have enough time to properly implement the new program? It could end up doing more harm than good.
I understand all of your concerns, but this program is designed to be efficient.
The wearable devices automatically collect data, the algorithms analyze it, and the recommendations are generated automatically, which Dr. Sanjay insists that it wouldn't require much extra work from healthcare providers.
But what about the patients? They already feel like they need some times with all the tests and questions. Adding another data collection increase the
anxiety. A report transparent with the patients, but the result show something unexpected and rather the legal emotional outcomes.
I understand these are all very concerned, but I will assure you, okay? I have all addressed this in my program, so you can just, you have to wait and wait for our results.
I still have my doubt. But I get your enthusiasm.
Maybe if we try a small group of volunteers first, see how it works before implementing to everyone.
They agree, let's start small, make sure it is ethical and feasible, then we can talk about wider implementation.
That's the deal, okay? I'm very happy to work with all of you here, and also I'm very happy these programs and for our success to celebrate. Thank you. And I will not disappoint also.
A tentative agreement has been made. The scene in the hospital lounge highlights the complex interplay of factors that can act as a barrier to research in healthcare practice. From workload concerns and ethical considerations to patient trust, and resource limitation, navigating the path from promising research to effective patient care requires open communication, collaboration, and a shared commitment to both scientific advancement and patient well-being. This role play can be extended to explore other barriers, let's say lack of financial resources and infrastructure, difficulty in recruiting and retaining patients to research studies, insufficient training and knowledge among healthcare professionals, competitions of poor resources and time between research and clinical activities. By discussing these additional challenges and potential solutions, we can raise awareness and contribute to creating a more research-friendly healthcare environment that ultimately benefits both patients and advancement of medical knowledge.